Mutaz Barshim and Gianmarco Tamberi. And these are two of the best in the world. And when it first came on, Barshim came up and he cleared this incredible height and he was fired up and his glasses flew off his face and he was ready to go and he's fired up and he's just doing his thing. And I remember seeing the announcer saying that he makes it look so easy, so effortless. And I thought to myself, that's incredible. Then they went to a clip with this guy named Gianmarco Tamberi, who's jumping right after him. And Gianmarco is someone who is considered also one of the best in the world. And he went right up after Barshim, and he went up and he cleared his height and he was all fired up. And he did some like basketball swoosh thing, and it was great. You know, you could see the gratitude and the relief all over his face all at the same time. And I love this stuff because I love watching people who paid the price. You see, we get to see the moments that they have where they get a few jumps and a few moments, but we don't see the thousands of hours that went into that one moment that we get to see. That when that person clears that bar, we don't see the thousands of times they didn't clear that bar. We don't see the thousands of times that they almost cleared the bar. We miss all of that. But when you're the best in the world, and you're competing against the best in the world, and you're at the highest level of sport in the Olympics, you're not allowed to clear the bar one time. You got to keep clearing it. And you got to go until the next person fails. And so Barshim went for the second run-up, and he cleared it again. And again, he was fired up. Because he's like, this is mine. Like, I run this. But what was so powerful is I saw Gianmarco clapping for him. And that showed me something. That when you're fighting for what you're fighting for, even your rivals can cheer you on. And then Tamberi went up, and what did he do? He went up again, and he cleared it again. And he started speaking. I think it was in Italian. I mean, I was excited. I'm sitting and watching this back and forth. I'm losing my mind. And at a certain point, it's just greatness versus greatness. The other athletes weren't even trying to. They knew that they were nowhere near the class of these two guys. That was it. But what happened was they went to this final height, 2.39 meters. And they get to this height, and again, it's going to be the same thing. Barshim goes first, and he has this beautiful run up and his beautiful glide. And as he's gliding up, boom, hits the bar. Covers his face, can't believe it. Boom, hits the bar. Puts his glasses back on and says, okay, it's all right. But he knows in the very next jump, the man who's his greatest competitor, the man who wants it so badly because in 2016 he was injured and wasn't able to compete in the Rio Olympics, he wants it so badly. And so Barshim's got to sit and watch this man who's driven, but he comes out walking, clapping for him. Why? Because you can respect your rivals. And as he's sitting there with his cast beside him, a reminder of how he missed Rio and how he wanted Tokyo, and he was told that he would probably never be able to compete again. Here he goes jumping over the bar, boom, he hits it. And so now, they both hit it. And because they both hit it, now the moment is where the administrator of the event comes up and says, okay, gentlemen. And what's crazy is that Tamberi, these two rivals, before anything is said, he goes and hugs him. He hugs him because he's looking at him like we've both been through something. And then Barshim says, can we have two golds? And in that moment, they slap hands. And Tamberi jumps in his arms. And let me tell you something. I lost my mind. I lost my ever-loving mind. I mean, I went nuts. I sat, I watched, I cried, I cheered. My heart was so filled because I thought about what these men went through. I saw Tamberi rolling around on the ground. I saw Barshim fist pumping. I saw these people who dedicated their lives to just these moments. And this one moment, they said, you're not gonna lose today because of me. We're both gonna win. Because we both had to go through something. Barshim injured in 2018. Tamberi injured in 2016. Both told, you're probably not gonna be able to compete at that level again. Both came back. And not only competed, they both shared the gold medal. But here's what was crazy. In order to leave the people behind that were not gonna be able to share that moment, they had to keep raising the bar. They had to go from 2.35 to 2.37. They had to keep raising it. And as they kept raising their bar just a little bit more, other people couldn't handle it and they started to fall off. And yet there they stood, because they raised their bar up just a little bit more than the competition could handle, then only the greatest remain. Let me ask you this. Where is your bar set? And are you willing to raise your bar? And when I say bar, I want you to look at B-A-R. Belief, actions, results. That's your bar. Because if you're willing to raise your bar, raise your belief, which raises your actions, which then allows for you to raise your results. If you're willing to raise your bar, and you don't have to raise your bar that much, just a little bit more. If you're willing to raise your bar, you leave everyone behind. And then here's what's going to happen. One day you're going to look and you're going to have your Olympic moment. And everyone has the opportunity for the Olympic moment. But in order to have that moment, you have to be willing to raise your bar. Where's your belief? Are you willing to raise your actions? And are you willing to go for the result? Are you willing to raise your bar? Because if you're willing to raise your bar, you'll be able to get all the things that are held from those who don't. Raise your bar and do it now.
Taste gold in Tokyo. This is an absolutely insane night in the stadium.
Mutaz, we all want to hear the story. Take us back to that moment. What was going through your mind when you decided to ask if it was possible to share the gold medal?
Of course, you know, we put a great show. The competition was amazing. It was the strongest high jump competition ever in the history. Gianmarco did a great job. I did a great job. Everybody else in the field did a great job. But when it comes to that 237, we both cleared that the first attempt. I know for a fact that me and Gianmarco being the past couple of years to a really, really serious injury that could be a career threatening, and just being able to come back from that and perform at the highest level, I wouldn't want him to be at the silver position, because I know what he's been through mentally and physically, and also I don't want myself to be in that silver position. So when we tie on that 237 and the judge comes to actually explain to us if we need a break off to actually somebody have gold or somebody have silver, and I just look at him and ask, can we both have gold? Can we have two gold? And he was like, yes, that's possible. And before he even finishes, we were celebrating. I look at Gianmarco, he looked back to me, and that's it. We know it.
Mutaz, you'll know that moment is being talked about as one of the great moments of sportsmanship in the history of athletics. What kind of reaction have you had to you doing that?
It, as I said, like literally people really love the people sharing the stories with me. I'm getting ton of messages from places I've never even heard about before. People say they get emotional. People say we've been crying. I mean, even at the village, I mean, when we came back to the village, we could not sleep. So we went for a walk, and literally we've been stopped by every single person we passed through. And the reaction was just insane, really. And I appreciate it. I love the support. I love that we did something that touched everybody's heart, and it's just an amazing, really.
What about people back home in Qatar? This must be such an important and amazing moment for them, too.
So right after I finished, you know, I got the phone with the president, and he saw me. He was so happy, he was so proud, and he said, one of the best things you did is sharing the gold. This just showing the true meaning of sport. You know, of course, the sport is very competitive. We are very competitive. We have it in our own self, but I mean, beyond all that, it's just, you know, love, peace, you know, integrity, unity, and the true sportsmanship.
If you actually took time to learn about how incredible you were, nothing would ever stop you.